in another survey confirming what we already think we know, which is that millennials want no part of this market.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, the UBS survey that we're looking at has said over time that about 50% of millennials say they don't really want any access to being in the market. They only have about less than 30% of their money in equities. And what it shows us is that a lot of the millennials are looking at other issues that are confronting them with their money. It's not that they're not saving, but they're saving and putting that money to work in other ways, paying off student loan debt, maybe perhaps trying to get that first home. They're looking at short-term needs that are really eating up their money, and they're not putting that money in the market. Now, some financial advisors say maybe it's not such a bad thing if they are putting their money in different pots and using it effectively in that way. But the key here is to realize that money that they do want to invest, money that they will need for retirement decades from now, make sure that money is put to work in equities. We're talking about people, though, that in the next 4 years, we're going to have about $9 trillion that's going to be controlled by millennials, and they're going to inherit some $36 trillion by 2060. So there's a lot of money at stake here, and that's why so many investment firms are really studying the way that they're using their money.
That's exactly it, by the way. And I was just going to add that there's a nice piece in the Wall Street Journal today about millennial saving rate. If you're wondering this very phenomenon, it's a negative rate, not unusual for this population, but again, to have that money that they're spending go towards paying down debt, for example, instead of in the market is going to be a problem.
And we have to understand, Kelly, why the millennials aren't doing this. It's because from their perspective, there's no incentive to do so. You take someone who's 35 years old, their entire recognition as an adult dates back to the year 2000 when they graduated college, and they saw the tech market blow up, then 9/11, then the 2008 credit crisis, housing crisis collapse, the stock market collapse, unemployment ensue. They've got massive student loan debt. And they're saying to themselves, why would anybody want to invest in that? And so they're not doing it.